am so glad you are all here this afternoon. We have a special visitor today, Mr. Jeff Woytovich from the Children's Alopecia Project is here to talk with us. And he came all the way from Pennsylvania.
Wow.
So that's very far. Is it a lot colder there?
Yes.
Yeah. Is there snow there?
Yes.
So he's probably loving being in Texas, right? So we are going to show him how great students are at St. Andrew Catholic School in Fort Worth, Texas by being very good listeners. Right?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
I'm going to start by telling you a story. And the story, it starts out sad. But I promise you it ends happy.
Yay.
So, as I'm driving the van, I started to cry. And I was crying so hard I had to pull over to the side of the road. And then my wife started to cry. And as we're crying, feeling sorry for ourselves, I hear a little voice in the back seat saying, "Daddy, why are you crying?" And it wasn't my oldest daughter. And the youngest daughter was a toddler, so I knew it wasn't her. I would have thought it was my third oldest because she never stopped talking. But it was my second oldest. It was Matt. I figured that she has a great smile. She has really big cheeks there. So I said, this is what we're going to do. I don't want people thinking you're sick. I don't want people to feel sorry for you. If they're going to look at you because you have no hair, I want them to feel happy. So this is what we're going to do. You're going to smile. Every time somebody looks at you and gives you one of those smiles, those sad smiles, I want you to give them the biggest smile you can. Because if you smile at them, I promise you they're going to smile right back at you. And they're going to feel better. Because then they'll say, "Well, she looks healthy. She has a big smile, so maybe she isn't sick." So I told her to go over to that side. I came to this side. I looked at my watch again. Nodded my head. This time, every time I saw somebody walk past her, saw her big smile, and she's doing it over and over and over. And if she's doing it over and over, that meant every single person that was looking at her, they were smiling right back. White blood cells, to the hair follicle, paralyze it, it just falls right out. Doesn't hurt, it's not contagious, no pain. They never made any medicine for alopecia. They don't understand how kids get it. They don't understand why some lose all their hair, some lose a little patch. Some will lose it and regrow and lose it and regrow. Some will lose it once and then it'll grow back and never fall out again. And others, like Maddie, it all fell out and it never grew back. I said, "It's like having a boo-boo." I said, "How many people have a boo-boo?" All these kids raised their hands. Just like that. And I said, "What happens as soon as you get cut? As soon as you get your boo, what's the first thing that happens?"
And it starts to hurt.
It hurts. As soon as it's done hurting and you look down, what happens to it? What's going on? It's going to bleed. So the blood will wash all the dirt out of it so that way it doesn't get infected. But that's not good enough. The body is saying, "Oh gosh, we have a cut. We need to get there and help protect it because we don't want germs getting in. We don't want any infection." So it sends white blood cells. Kids with alopecia, kids with an autoimmune disease, they have more white blood cells than other kids. And some of them get mistaken. They don't understand what they're supposed to do. So kids with alopecia that have more white blood cells, it goes right to the hair. It makes it fall out. Just like the white blood cells, it's trying to help the cut. And what goes over that cut when it's done bleeding, and you have a band-aid on, what forms on the cut? A scab. That scab, that's white blood cells. protecting the body. So I said, Maddie, are you ready to take your hat off? She said, yes. So she took her hat off, and all the kids in the room all looked at her head and stared at her. Probably for five seconds, but it was the longest 5 seconds of my life because I was waiting for somebody to point at her or laugh at her or say something. But no one did. You know what they did? They looked back at me and they wanted to show me their boobs. So I'm thinking, wow, what a bunch of great kids. I think she's going to be okay. And she was. That first year of kindergarten, she was never made fun of. She was never ignored. She was never picked on or bullied. In first grade, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth grade, seventh, eighth grade, then she went to high school. 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, 12th grade, she was never made fun of. Now she's a freshman in college, and she still has never been made fun of. So I knew that once I got over being angry and sad, I knew that I had to do something to make sure that Maddie was taken care of. Because I wanted her self-esteem to be great. Who knows what self-esteem means? What's self-esteem? Your belief system? It's how you feel about yourself. So if you have a good self-esteem, you feel good about yourself. If you have a low self-esteem, you might think, I'm too short, I'm too big, I'm too tall, I'm too slow. You don't feel good about yourself. And kids, whether you have hair or not, all kids should feel good about themselves. It shouldn't matter what you look like. Because every single person in this room is original. Everyone's unique. There's not another person like you. Even if you have twins, you're so different. Who knows what the Mona Lisa is? What's the Mona Lisa? Attractive painting, is it? I mean, it's just a woman who's barely smiling. But you know what? There's only one of them. And it's in a museum in France. And it's priceless. It is worth so much money that you can't say how much money it's worth. Because no money in the world could ever buy it. That's how precious it is. It's an original. If I went there and I took a picture of it and I gave everyone in here a copy, would those copies be, would they be worth anything? Maybe a dollar? But the original is priceless. Everyone in here, you're all priceless because you're all original. Never try and be a copy of someone else because copies aren't worth anything. You guys are exactly the way you're supposed to be. You might change in a week or in a month or a year, and when you change, you're going to be perfect then, too. People change all the time. How many people have brown hair? Raise your hand. Okay, look around. A lot of kids have brown hair. And really dark hair. Brown, black, whatever you do. Okay, put your hands down. How about who has blonde hair? It's a lot less. How about red hair? It's now that's even less. How about no hair? You have one. And I'm going to call it the old fashioned. I've been doing this for 30 years. So, I'm just curious. Kids with brown hair, are you going to make fun of kids with blonde hair?
No!
Kids with blonde hair, are you going to make fun of kids with red hair?
No!
And kids with no hair, are you going to make fun of kids with hair?
No!
It's silly because since we're all different, and we're all unique and original, that means if I make fun of you, you can make fun of me because I'm just as different. And that would be silly. So we don't make fun of people because they're tall or short or big or skinny or have brown hair, red hair, blonde hair, or no hair, or if they have dark skin or light skin, or if they speak differently. Everyone's different. So let me show you one more video. So I started a nonprofit called the Children's Alopecia Project. And I did it because I knew that there were other parents that felt like me. And I didn't want them to feel sad and angry. I wanted them to make sure that their children with alopecia had the best self-esteem they could possibly have. Because it's the thing that kids need more than anything. And if you have good self-esteem, you feel like you can do anything. Here we go. Everyone freeze. Are you guys making crazy faces?
Yes.
All right, here we go.